Some 2 months ago, or was it three months ago, we have undergone a difficult of xenophobia that has spread all over our nation. As a nation that has undergone a lot of problems, and now we united as a rainbow nation, that now we fight against the xenophobia, which was the new disease that was erupting. Everybody, church leaders, faith groups, everybody has fought so that this new disease, besides fighting HIV and AIDS, we have to fight xenophobia also. Because we need prosperity in this nation. We need to show a good example to the people of Africa. Because many nations in Africa suffer because of their own poor quality of leadership. It was dark days for the foreigners of this nation. Foreigners are not wild animals, not wild pigs, but people who need care, love, so that they can be sustained, they can be integrated to the community. Let's come to this province called the Friendly Province of Eastern Cape. This is Eastern Cape. This is where I stayed for 12 years. The friendly city of Eastern Cape, the backbone of freedom, the backbone of this nation. It was not possible for xenophobia to spread in our province because we are a friendly province and we fight because we know what the freedom is. A good example, somebody like me, who was in this nation for the last 12 years, I'm a taxpayer. If I will be attacked, I must go back down the line again 12 years to develop my life. During the time of xenophobia, the MEC Christine Martin, director, mayor, and many other leaders walking from place to place, location to location, to make sure that nothing is going to happen in this place. They came and they speak. They give a voice. They speak to the nation. They speak to the locals. They speak to the city. And they spoke to everybody else saying that no xenophobia. We say no to xenophobia. And we were successful.
What we were doing from the police side is part of my constitutional obligations. At the time when xenophobia was rife in our country, our provincial commissioner decided that xenophobia must not occur in the Eastern Cape. And he gave us a strong mandate to come up with whatever programs, social crime prevention projects, visible policing, in order to make sure that we don't have such occurrences. So, from the police's side, the police in the Eastern Cape was effective. I also would like to say to Somalian community here, it was basically a two-way channel what happened. We protected them and they also assisted us. There were instances that certain individuals, you know, amongst the community tried to set this thing alight of xenophobia. But because of the cooperation of the community, they said, no, we will not participate. I am dealing with the constitution which tells me that I must protect the inhabitants of the country, and that is my mandate. Let us respect these people because they are inhabitants. They are just ordinary citizens in the community, and we should not fear. And obviously, I think the provincial commissioner will also be happy about the fact that he can say in his province, the Somalians has acknowledged the police for their efforts. So thank you very much.
Firstly, I want to thank the Somali community for this award. You know what happens is, I just called the guys together. We were a group actually and said, guys, let's go sit and strategize around this thing. Kasim would remember we didn't sleep. From my side, you know, I always thank God for creating opportunities. Opportunities are being created, and if I don't see the opportunities and make use of it, it will pass. Remember the words that if you don't do it, God just find somebody else to do it. And I said, he'll just find somebody else to do it. And when you realize that I should have been the one to do that, it's too late. You always think you're the only one. You'll be surprised. So remember, when the opportunity appears, let us just take it and run with it. Thank you.